going on, everyone? Welcome to Channel Anderson. Today we're going to be talking about the debacle between the recommended fluid for Mercedes and the recommended fluid for Chrysler for the same transmission that's in this car now out of the Chrysler Crossfire. Now Mercedes says it has to meet Mercedes spec 235.10, and Chrysler says it has to meet Chrysler spec MS-9224. So there's been many debates about this online. The biggest thing that I'm trying to solve is when the transmission is cold, 1 to 2 gear shift is just not as smooth as the rest of them. And once it gets warmed up, it's totally fine. From reading extensively online of all the things I could find, it seems like the best fluid to use is the Mercedes spec 235.10, which is actually Febi, and it's on FCB Euro for cheap. So I figured might as well try it out. It was like $11 or $12 for a quart, which is cheaper than all the other things that I've used so far. I've tried Valvoline Synchromesh. It's MT90 Redline in here right now, and it's been working good. It works better than the Valvoline Synchromesh, honestly, but still not perfect when it's cold. So when I drive the car right now, when the transmission is cold, I usually just let it warm up until I do a 1 to 2 gear shift. I can do it if I, you know, kind of pause in between and it'll be fine. But I just figured, you know, until I get it solved all the way or as close as I can, I'll just wait till the car warms up till I actually shift 1 to 2. So I usually start in second gear a lot anyways, because with the V8, you really don't need to start in first. The gearing is pretty tall in this transmission. And with the C55 306 gears in the back, 306 or 307, I always forget. It's a very tall first gear, meaning it's pretty short. So, like I'll show you here. If I wait right there, goes in a second fine, but I have to pause in between. If I try to just go in right away, it's a little crunchy. You can tell the synchros are not all the way happy. So that's the thing that I'm trying to eliminate. That goes away once it's warm, like I said, but when it's cold, it's always there. It has gotten better, actually. When I was using the Synchromesh from Valvoline, and I love Valvoline products, by the way, I've used them for a long time with good results, but just doesn't quite match up for this transmission. But when I was using that Synchromesh from Valvoline, the 1 to 2 when it was cold was really bad. And even second to third when it was cold was bad. This one is just still a little bit notchy when it's cold. So there, right there, just started from second and then going into third, and no issues. So yeah, it's really only the 1 to 2 that I'm trying to figure out right now. I'll get on the freeway here and I'll show you guys kind of just rolling through the gears up to freeway speed. It's a little cold in here right now, I gotta turn the heat on. So some upcoming videos for you guys. I'm gonna be doing a Recaro seat install soon. The one thing I'm gonna miss about having the stock seats is the heated seats, but not the end of the world. The rest of the car being warm is more important for me being warm, I guess, but the heated seats are nice. And what else? I have a custom shift that I'm gonna look at installing today. That would probably get its own video, but just want to tell you guys. So here we are. We are in fourth right now. I can't really go any faster than I am because there's cars right in front of me. There's fifth. Fast lane. All right, and we're up to speed. We're at 70 miles per hour at about 2100 RPM. So The other thing that is supposedly supposed to help the 1-2 gear shift is reducing the fluid amount from 1.8 quarts to 1.6 quarts. 1.9 quarts to 1.6 quarts, or 1.8 liters to 1.5 liters. So, I have my special kind of syringe that I was using to measure it out when I took a little bit of fluid out of this one. So this time around, I'm gonna drain out the fluid. I'm gonna see how much is in there, because I don't know how much I really took out, because I kind of went back and forth with it. So I'm gonna see how much I take out, and then I'm just gonna put in 1.6 quarts. I bought 3 quarts from FCP Euro, that way I have an extra quart and a half on hand. So we'll see, I'll try to measure it out perfect and get it exactly to 1.6 or 1.5 liters. Warmed up and absolutely fine. So it's an interesting matter to try to solve in the first place. Oh, BMW got a little mad at me. Big things is the MB spec fluid is a 75 weight 85, but from reading online and from having it in person now, there's no way it's a 75 weight 85. That's just what they label it as. The fluid is really, really thin, as you guys will see here in a second. And there's no way it's an actual gear oil. And it's funny because Chrysler's MS-9224, or whatever it is actually an engine oil spec. So they use, I believe, 520 synthetic oil. That was a nice Golf R right there passing by. So they use motor oil in their transmissions. They say that's the, you know, highest lubricity they could choose for a fluid. So they use synthetic motor oil. Now, the MB fluid, actually, if I put it next to a motor oil compared to a gear oil, it's much closer to the viscosity of a motor oil, and it would be somewhere probably close to a 5W20 or 5W30. So people have tried all kinds of things in these transmissions. I've read everywhere from actual gear oils to synchromesh oils to automatic transmission fluid to motor oil to all kinds of things. People's favorites seem to be the Royal Purple Synchromesh, which I'm not a big fan of Royal Purple products, but people seem to love it for these transmissions specifically. And then the other thing is people like AMSOIL Synchromesh, which is actually like a 5W20 or 5W30 related formula. And then the top choice that I see is people just sticking with the MB235-10 or .10, which is actually a Febi fluid. Don't pay the extra $20 for the Mercedes fluid. Just get the Febi, same exact fluid. You can cross-reference part numbers online, same exact stuff. So I'll link everything below, but yeah.
All right, so I'm gonna try to make this part quick, but here's the fluid that I was talking about. It's a Febi. It says it's a 75 weight GL4. Let's see if it has the actual part number on here somewhere. I don't see, but I'll post it in the link. But it does say what specifications it meets. And there it is, MB235-10. So you know it's good for that. So yeah, Mercedes doesn't say that this is a fluid, but they have gotten approved to have this on there. So you know it's the exact same fluid. It's just one of those Mercedes things where they don't release who exactly their fluid vendors are. So yeah, I'm gonna get these loaded up and start draining out the old oil.
I'm gonna use the FCP adapter that I got. Actually works okay on these quart bottles. Not perfect because threads don't match up exactly, but I got it on there. Shouldn't be moving around. So yeah, this bottle has 1.06 US quarts. So I will do my math real quick and make sure I get exactly what I need out of here. All right, so that's finishing draining right now. I'm just gonna let it go for, I don't know, 5 or so more minutes, just try to get all the little drops out of there. It's not gonna be all of it, but it'll get close. And then after that, we will fill in the new fluid. Here's how much came out of there. I forget, I'm gonna take this bucket out. I know this bucket has measurements on it right now. That's why I put this one on there. So I'll see how much is in that bowl and go from there. All right, so I got the fluid out, changed. It's a bit of a hassle, to be honest, just because, I mean, changing differential fluid or tranny fluid or anything like that where you have to go to the top fill hole is always kind of a pain in the butt. But initial impressions, I feel like it did make a positive change, actually. Even just standing still and going through the gears before the car was moving felt a bit smoother, especially going into reverse has been a little bit notchy as well when you're first doing it when it's cold. Now the transmission was a little bit warm, obviously. It was sitting there for a while because I was probably there for an hour and a half while I was changing it, just doing other stuff. I actually deleted the fog lights while I was waiting. So it drained all the way out. I flushed a little bit of the new fluid through before I filled it up. And yeah, first impressions, it feels good. It's really hard to get exactly like 1.6 quarts or 1.5 liters just because when you're, whatever apparatus you're using to put the fluid in, you're gonna have some of the fluid left over in the tubing. So it's not a perfect science exactly, but I just try to get it as close as I could between, you know, like 1.5 and 1.6 quarts basically. I'm close to that 1.6 quarts mark, so it should be good. So the true test, just like last time when I tested the fluid, the true test will come on a cold start or a cold morning when I'm going for a drive. The weather's been in like about the 50 to 55 range. In the mornings, it's around 40 to 45. So I'll get some more testing data in the next few days to see how it does on the cold starts. So. Feels good. Driving manual is so much better, you guys. I love, like, automatics are great. I love them, especially like dual clutches and things like that. They're amazing, they shift amazing. It's fun having the paddle shifts, but nothing compares, man. Manual is just more fun. It's just the way it is. There's no getting around it. There's a reason why people do automatic to manual swaps. By the way, without the automatic, there's no more rev limiter, so you can actually bounce off the limiter if you don't watch yourself. I may have done it once or twice. No, I did it once on accident, just to test if it would do it, and then I shifted right away. Yeah, not trying to bounce off the limiter, but just was curious. Not much more to see, to be honest. I won't make this video too long, but I hope you guys enjoy, and I just wanted you guys to update with that whole debacle of Mercedes versus Chrysler fluid and see if it made a noticeable change. I will update this video in the comments. I'll pin the comments as I go through and see how it's doing on cold starts so you guys can get an idea of if anything is changing. But so far, so good. It's not a drastic change, but I can definitely feel a change for sure. Especially through first, second, and third. So, here we go.